Stand you're taking.
That's correct.
And Lieutenant Flynn, and I'm pretty sure I figured out what happened in his case. And I cast no aspersions upon him, just the opposite. I think he's an American hero. You know, this is the thanks you get for 30 years of serving your country for, you know, far less money than you would ever get in the private sector. But in his particular case, the two FBI agents that interviewed him, none of them thought he was lying. Comey didn't think he was lying. So why did he agree to the one charge that he admitted he lied? Number one, he ran out of money. He couldn't afford to pay his lawyers. He had to sell his house. And what I really suspect is, and this is a trick or pressure point that prosecutors often use, well, you know, I guess we're just going to have to, you know, your son worked with you in your business. We're just going to have to, we're going to be going after him too, just so you know. And my guess, and this is total speculation, is he said, I got it. I'll sign it. And as a father, he dove on the sword for his son or somebody else in his family. Now, does that sound plausible to you? Because that's what I believe probably happened.
I believe it's exactly what happened, given my experience, Sean, and General Flynn's a huge American hero in my book. And they're doing the same to me. They'll say, you know, your family will be bankrupt. You'll lose your jobs. You'll not have any way to work. We'll be putting you in prison soon. You're going to be guilty. You'll be separated from your wife. May never see your children or grandchildren as a free man again. And I said, if that's what you want to do to me, Mr. Mueller, come get me, because I'm not swearing to a lie, no matter how much you threaten me.
Did you ever meet Mueller?
No, I've never met Mueller.
No. Is Andrew Weissman in any of these meetings?
I've never met Andrew. He's never been in any of these. It's always been the Jeannie Rhee, Aaron Zelinsky, and Andrew Goldstein.
Let me ask you, and I asked you this on TV last night, because I got to know you when you and Jim O'Neill wrote the book that was a number one bestseller, Unfit for Command. And I'm reading all these things about you, you know, and I asked you about it last night because I didn't fully hear your answer, to be very blunt. It's hard sometimes on TV. That you didn't believe the moon landings had really happened, or you believe that 9/11 was an inside job. And I'm asking for a specific reason. I know that you went into the issue of Barack Obama and his birth certificate. That for me was never my issue, really. I just thought these, you know, produce the stupid thing and we move on, and eventually it happened. But do you really believe those things, or are people lying about you?
People are lying about me. I don't believe those things at all, Sean. I think we landed on the moon.
But you've seen it as I have, correct?
Yes, and my critics like to demonize me making up things that I've never believed and I don't avow. And I'll acknowledge that, you know, I push the envelope. I'm an investigative journalist. I'm willing to ask questions, you know, that go against the government explanation of things. Now,
well, why didn't you claim a First Amendment privilege that you don't give away sources in any regard?
Well, Sean, I mean, could have done that. I could have. But I went in, honestly, to try to help. I didn't see I had done anything wrong. I didn't see anyone had done it. Not Roger Stone. Certainly not the president. I don't even like Russian salad dressing. So I don't have anything to do with Russia.
Well, that's probably the only thing. I like Russian salad dressing. All right, let me ask you very bluntly. What do they want you to say?
And they want me to say, let me say that here's my contact with Julian Assange, which I did not have. And this person told me everything Julian Assange had. I told it to Roger Stone, so Roger Stone could tell it to Bannon or the president. And they were collude. This was their channel to tell us Assange when to drop things, what he had, how did they want to create this false narrative that Donald Trump, through Roger Stone, through me, to WikiLeaks, was giving instructions as to how to use these stolen DNC emails to harm Hillary Clinton. That's what they wanted me to
say. So now this is after the DNC emails came out just before the Democratic National Convention, correct?
Correct.
All right. And if I recall correctly, there was tons of speculation. Well, does he have anything else? Does it, you know, nobody knew. There was like this shroud of mystery all over the place, right?
That's right. Everybody was asking. Everybody, what does Assange have? It was a question on everyone's mind at that time.
You know, I had found in my interviews with him, he's very careful with every word he says. And it was, you know, and I wanted to know, because my feeling was that where, if he did get this information, wherever he says he get it from, maybe it's a Russian cutout and maybe he didn't know. Maybe it was Russia and he just didn't tell me the truth. Maybe it was, who knows? It could have been 100 different things. Maybe it was China. You know, Hillary's emails were, we understand, were hacked by at least, what, 6 foreign intelligence services. You know, I mean, it's insane that she's not in any trouble and that she got an exoneration before even an investigation. So what can you tell us about the joint defense agreement that you had with President Trump's legal team?
David Gray and Jay Sekulow, the team of the president's lawyers, were entering into an informal, it was never signed, defense agreement. My understanding, what I told David, and I never participated in any of these conversations, I didn't hear them, because I'm not a lawyer. This was lawyer to lawyer. And what my instructions were to David were let the president know through Jay Sekulow what's going on with Mueller from our perspective, what we're seeing, what we're being asked. Share that with the president. Don't ask for advice. We don't want the president's advice. We don't want any coordination. It's a one-way communication, David. And this, David affirms that this is how he did it, where we share information with Jay Sekulow and don't expect anything in return.
When Roger wrote you about, you know, get to Organization One, which we now know to be WikiLeaks and Assange, you never got there, but did you have or know somebody that had contact with Assange that could have given you information that you believed to be accurate?
No, I had no person who was an intermediary or a go-between or a contact with Assange that told me what Assange had. I had no intermediate contact at all. No direct contact, no intermediate contact, no contact whatsoever of any kind with Julian Assange.
So there's no chance of any conspiracy to get stolen emails from anybody. You never hacked anybody, I assume. Is that correct?
No, I never did.
Okay, so they really don't have any underlying crime for you at all, do they?
No, and they're furious at me because I broke their chain. I couldn't give them the piece that connected Roger to Assange, and now I'm a bad dog. Now I've lied, and now I'm going to spend the rest of my life in prison, and so be it.
So, you know, we're back to the, it's like the Martha Stewart case. I mean, if you can't get them on the underlying crime, and one fact is misremembered, and you didn't remember, you literally are talking about emails from almost 2 years ago, or past
Correct.
2 years ago.
Correct.
So you have two-year-old emails. I don't know how many emails you get a day, but I got a bunch. And text messages, I had a bunch.
60,000 emails. When I finally reloaded, I had 60,000 emails in that computer.
When you went in, had you read those emails to refresh your memory?
No, I couldn't because I wanted to give them my laptop, which was nearly broken, in the condition when I stopped using it. And so I was afraid if I reloaded 2016, I would destroy its
the only one that gets away with that is Hillary Clinton. You get to delete them and then acid wash it with bleach bit, and then you get to have somebody bust up your devices and remove SIM cards. And, of course, in her case, you know, she's free as a bird. I mean,